Now that we have Altium Designer set up, let's dive into the tool. The Help drop-down menu provides quick access to further documentation for the user on various topics. For example, clicking on the new in Altium Designer opens up a web page showing the current updates and improvements have been made. Likewise, clicking on the Exploring Altium Designer opens up a similar web page. One useful tool feature in the Help drop-down menu is the shortcut keys. These shortcuts improve efficiency, and most experienced users make frequent use of them. Let's open up the Components panel. Currently, we're looking at our workspace library. We'll do this so that we can show how to modify your workspace. The panels can be rearranged by simply clicking on the top of the panel and dragging them. The panels can also be separated from the main window. Normally, I dock them on the right or the left of the main window. Let's open up an example project so we can explore the operation of panels within the tool. Here we have an example project opened, and we are looking at the schematics in the main window. The Altium Designer tool window can be configured to suit your preferences. Typically, panels are changed by the user to suit your particular working needs. The Components panel right now is collapsed at this point. To open it up, hover over it with the mouse, and the panel will open. This panel collapses when not actively being used due to the thumbtack at the top right of the panel being rotated as you see. This is an example of a non-pinned panel. Clicking on the pin rotates it with the pin facing down. The effect is to pin the panel, keeping it open. You can switch back and forth between pinned and not pinned by simply clicking on the icon. Panels can be resized by moving the mouse over the edge until it changes to a double vertical line, and then left-clicking on the edge and holding it, moving it either to increase or decrease the panel size as you desire. To open additional panels based on the currently active main window, click on the Panel button at the bottom right of the window. This will show a menu of possible panels to open. Here we will add the Properties panel. Now we move on to a most important tool feature, Preferences. We access the Preferences via the gear icon at the top right of the window. This opens up the Preferences pop-up window. The listing of various groups of preferences is on the left, including System, Schematic, PCB Editor, to name but a few. While we'll not go too deeply into these at this point, they affect how the tool works in the various arenas listed, such as for schematics. For now, we'll just use the defaults. Once you gain experience with the tool, you may consider changing them to fit your preferences. Under the main entries here, there are a number of subcategories, as you can see in the schematics or the PCB editor. One of the useful tool features is the shortcut. Shortcuts are keystroke sequences that help speed the user. One such shortcut is V and then F, which is View, Fit All Objects, to show all the objects in the active document. Likewise, V followed by D shows the whole document. One easy way to learn specific shortcuts is to remember them from the pull-down menus. For example, clicking on the View drop-down menu, we see that the V is underlined. In the submenu, we see entries with underlined letters, such as D and the Fit Document entry. So therefore, V and D would be the Fit Document entry option. The menus show the shortcut keystrokes, and users will typically start to learn the ones they use all the time if you pay attention to the underlined letters. Altium uses projects to store and organize design information. In this typical example project, we see the project file, and indented under it are a number of groups of files. Under the source files are the schematics and the PCB. Note, the schematics have a top-level schematic with an indented set of files underneath, indicating that this project design is a hierarchical one. Under the settings is the outjob file. This is used for generating needed files for manufacturing. In this particular project, there is also local libraries. This is allowed but unusual, as most users would rely on a central library. To close the project, right-click on the project file in the project panel. You could click Close Project Documents to keep the project loaded in the panel if desired, or select Close Project to close all of the project files and the project. If there are any changes to the project's files, it will prompt you to save them. You can save all the changed files, or some, or none, as needed. To reopen a recent project, click on the File drop-down menu and click on Recent Projects to see a list of previously open projects. Just like this. So let's jump back to the SL1 example project. Looking now at the open project, we can see that there are a number of schematic files with the top listed and the rest indented. Again, this is a hierarchical design. This contains a number of blocks at the top level representing sub-circuit schematics. Clicking on each of them, we can see their design. Each of the blocks point to a particular sub-schematic. For example, clicking on the lower left block with the reference U_SL_power, we see the properties panel provides us with the file name of the schematic that this block is referencing. To navigate through the design, you can click on a block to see which schematic file it links to, or holding down the control key, double-click on the block, and this will open the reference schematic sheet. Clicking on the top-level file, we can dive again into another schematic the same way. Here we see the components and all of their connections. In this schematic, the SL-LCD-SW-LED-2E, we see an example both of wires for connections and a bus. The bus has the net label of LCD_DB with left and right square brackets, with the leading bus indicator number being 7, followed by two dots, and then the ending bus indicator of 0. Again, this is an 8-bit bus. Looking at the wires attached to the bus, we can see how to select individual bus nets using the correct label, or LCD-DB, and then a number. Connections are made off the schematic sheet using ports. The port names are external facing and may or may not match the local schematic net names. In this particular port, LCD_RS, it matches the wire's net label that it's connected to, but it's not required. Selecting the LCD-RS port and holding the control key down, we double-click on it, traverses us back up the hierarchy to show the port at the top-level block along with the connections that are made. This allows for tracing a signal through the hierarchy and is especially useful for someone who may not understand the design to follow the flow. Clicking anywhere on the schematic will clear the highlighting. You can follow a signal down into the lower schematic by simply holding the control key down and double-clicking on the port. Just to further illustrate the connections on a schematic, looking at the net label user IO0 on this wire, this wire is electrically connected to the same named net here. Using net labels allows for connections within a schematic and avoids the rat nest of wires. Normally, we can use wires without net labels to provide connections, in this case between R10 and U2 pin 2. Altium Designer employs a unified database. This is a representation of the components and connections in the design. When capturing a design, the database is actively recompiled in tracks. This allows for users to seamlessly traverse between schematics and the PCB. Using the property panel selection filter to only enable a component, we select U1. Note that if more than one component could be picked, the tool will list the options for picking. Going to the schematics, we can see now that U1 is highlighted. This works bidirectionally between the schematics and the PCB. Selecting a component in the schematic will highlight it in the PCB as well. Here we've discussed the tool features, introduced the concept of projects, showed an example of hierarchical design, and discussed connectivity using net labels, wires, and ports.